Loft friends. In case you don't remember me, my name's Jennifer, and I used to teach the first hour loft class. And I am so excited that I get to introduce our Bible story to you today. You know, I heard a fun story this week about a man who had a bunch of baseball cards, and he took them to a thrift store to try to sell them, to basically get rid of them, but maybe see if he could get a little bit of money for them. Anyway, turns out he had several vintage baseball cards that were actually worth a lot of money, and he got a fair bit for them. Sometimes you can have something really valuable in front of you and not know it. Well, in Jesus's time, in the Bible story, this is exactly what happened. The people had Jesus, the Messiah, the Son of God, walking amongst them, and they didn't even believe that he was the Messiah. Jesus, this story takes place just after Jesus had fed over 5,000 people with 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. Then Jesus's disciples, they crossed the sea on a boat, and the people knew that Jesus didn't go with them. Well, they were really surprised to find out the next day that Jesus was with his disciples. They didn't know that Jesus had walked on water in the middle of the night to his disciples. The crowd had more questions for Jesus. Let's find out what they talked about.
A crowd of people went looking for Jesus. They had seen him perform miracles, like feeding more than 5,000 people. They went to Capernaum and found Jesus on the other side of the Sea of Galilee. "Teacher, when did you get here?" they asked Jesus. Jesus answered, "Why are you looking for me? Did you want to find me because I can do miracles? Or were you looking for me because I gave you food? If you're seeking food, remember that food on earth will perish. Search for food that gives eternal life. The Son of Man will give it to you. This food never goes bad." The people asked, "What does God want us to do?"
Jesus said, "Believe in the one whom he has sent." The people said, "What will you do for us to make us believe? Will you do another miracle?" The people wanted bread from heaven, like Moses and the Israelites received in the wilderness. Jesus said, "God the Father gives true bread from heaven. I am the bread of life. No one who comes to me will ever be hungry, and no one who believes in me will ever be thirsty again."
Jesus explained that the Father had sent him to do God's plan. God's plan is that everyone who sees Jesus, God the Son, and believes in him will have eternal life. The Jews began complaining because Jesus said he came from heaven. "Isn't this the son of Joseph?" they asked. Jesus said again, "I am the bread of life. I came from heaven. Unless you eat my flesh and drink my blood, you will not live forever." When Jesus said this, many of his followers said, "This teaching is hard. Who can accept it?"
Many of the people who had followed Jesus turned away from him. Jesus asked his 12 disciples, "Do you want to go away too?" Peter answered, "Lord, where would we go? You have the words of eternal life. We believe and know that you are the Holy One of God."
Jesus wanted to do more than fill people's stomachs. He wanted to give them true life. Jesus' teachings were hard to understand. When Jesus talked about his flesh and blood, he was talking about his death and resurrection. When we trust in Jesus, he gives us the gift of eternal life.
After the crowd saw Jesus miraculously feed the 5,000, they went looking for him, for the wrong reasons though. Rather than following him because they believed that he was the Messiah, they followed him because they believed that he could feed their empty stomachs. Jesus wanted people to follow him because they believed that he was the Messiah, not because they were hungry for physical food. See, he wanted people to believe that if just by believing in him, that they could have eternal life. But people had a hard time believing Jesus and his teachings. See, they knew that Jesus was born in Nazareth. They knew that his dad's name was Joseph. How could he come from heaven when they knew who his dad was and where he was born? And they didn't really understand or agree with all of Jesus' teachings. Jesus was telling his followers that they needed to eat his flesh and drink his blood to have eternal life. But is that what Jesus meant? Was Jesus really telling people to eat his skin and drink his blood to have eternal life? They didn't know that Jesus was soon going to die on the cross, that his blood was going to be shed, so that we would all get the gift of salvation, that our punishment would be paid. So when we have the Lord's Supper, we remember when we eat the bread and when we drink the juice, we remember and trust in Jesus's death and his resurrection.
Beloved of the Father, you were born into this world, living in our limitations and our hurt. The promise of a healing Savior, fully God and fully man, the sacrifice for all, the spotless Lamb. The great I Am redeemed us with his outstretched. Jesus Messiah. could ever face. You were perfect in your nature, never sinned in heaven.